Shalom, Mr. Most High Christ Blessed. I'm Captain Zab, and to my left I have
Soldier Perez.
Today on 15 Minutes with the Captains, we will be discussing, is God sexist? Let's start with this, Galatians chapter 4, verse 16.
This is the book of Galatians chapter 4, verse 16.
Okay.
Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
Are we going to be your enemies now because we read the truth out of the Bible? What is the truth? The truth is, guess what? Is God sexist? No. No, God is not sexist. Let's look at the scripture. Let's see what the scriptures say. Come on.
This is the book of Galatians, chapter 3 and verse 26.
Galatians 3, 26. Let's do it.
For ye are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus.
Okay.
For as many of you as have been baptized into Christ have put on Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female.
There's neither male nor female. The Lord said it's neither male nor female. Does that sound like a sexist statement to you? Let's look up the definition of sexist.
The definition of sexist.
Yeah.
Characterized by or showing prejudice, stereotyping or discrimination, typically against women on the basis of sex.
So does God discriminate against women? Let's read that scripture again.
This is Galatians chapter 3 and verse 28. There's neither Jew nor Greek. There's neither bond nor free. There's neither male nor female. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
Again, that does not sound like a sexist statement to me. It says, male nor female, you are all one in Christ Jesus. Come on.
And if ye be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seed, and heirs according to the promise.
And heirs according to the promise. So guess what? If you keep the commandments, just like if I keep the commandments, we both get into the kingdom of heaven. You got to keep the commandments. I got to keep the commandments. You wear the fringes. I wear the fringes. You keep the Sabbath. I keep the Sabbath. You abide by the dietary laws. I abide by the dietary law. God is not sexist. But what's the problem? Let's go to Titus chapter 2, verse 3.
This is the book of Titus chapter 2 and verse 3.
Yeah.
The aged women likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness, not false accusers, not given to much wine, teachers of good things, that they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands and to love their children, to be discreet, chaste, keepers at home, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God be not blasphemed.
So these are the roles that the Lord put in place for you. But what's the problem? You have lost value in that role. You no longer see that role as important. You have allowed what America has taught you to supersede what the Bible has said. You have allowed what America has taught you and the feminist movement to determine what you believe a woman's role should be instead of what the Bible says. Let's jump over to Sirach chapter 36, verse 21.
Come on. This is the book of Sirach chapter 36 and verse 21.
Okay.
A woman will receive every man, yet is one daughter better than another.
So is a one woman better than another? Of course she is. The ones that do what God says, she's better than those women that don't do what God says. Come on.
The beauty of a woman cheereth the countenance, and a man loveth nothing better.
A man loveth nothing better than what? A beautiful woman, be it internally and externally. Right? We need that woman to have that inner beauty as well. Come on.
If there be kindness.
So this is what inner beauty looks like. Kindness. Go ahead.
Meekness.
Meekness.
And comfort in her tongue. Then is not her husband like other men.
Her husband is not like other men. Why? Because he can be that Psalms 82 and 6 brother that he's supposed to be, a God amongst men. He can be that because he has that helpmeet that's going to have his back, right? Let's go back. Come on, Sirach.
Sirach, chapter 36 and verse 21.
Uh-huh.
A woman will receive every man, yet is one daughter better than another. The beauty of a woman cheereth the countenance, and a man loveth nothing better.
Uh-huh.
If there be kindness, meekness, and comfort in her tongue, then is not her husband like other men. He that getteth the wife beginneth the possession. A help like unto himself and a pillar of rest.
So she can be a help. What? She gonna help that man to be that God-like man he's supposed to be. Come on, verse 25.
Where no hedge is, there the possession is spoiled.
Where there's no order. Where there's no order amongst men. Where there's no order amongst us as a nation. Guess what? We are spoiled because we have no order. Come on, read that again. Read 25.
Where no hedge is, there the possession is spoiled. And he that hath no wife will wander up and down mourning.
Guess what? He gonna wander up and down mourning because that wife has a vital role to play. Our sisters have a vital role to play. And the Lord doesn't sound like he's being sexist if he's continued to elaborate how important the role is that a woman has to play. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 31 and verse 23.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 31 and verse 23. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land.
Okay, so of course, a brother's going to be known in the gates. Why? Because he has that help me that has helped to transition him into from a man to a guy. He has been, she has been that support to help that brother to grow. But this is the problem, Israel. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 7, verse 11. Let's see what's happening today.
This is the book of Proverbs chapter 7, and verse 11.
Uh-huh.
She is loud and stubborn. Her feet abide not in her house.
So that's what our women do right now, right? They loud and stubborn. They want to wear the trousers. They want to run the show. They want to lead the army. They want to sit on top of the government. They think that means that the Lord is not sexist. If they get to do everything that a man can do, then he's not sexist. Guess what? It's divine order in this thing. It's not women can do whatever a man can do. That's what America has taught you. But what has allowed and destroyed our nation is us believing, our sisters believing that they should be able to do everything that a man should do. Let's jump over to 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 7.
This is the book of 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 7. Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel.
So it's as the weaker vessel. So can women go out and fight in the army? Of course they can. Should they? No. Should they sit on and lead the government? No. Could they? Yes. But the Lord said, what again? Read that again.
Giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel.
Uh-huh.
And as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers be not hindered.
But he said again, heirs together. Again, those don't sound like sexist statements. Again, those are statements that the Lord says you do have value in the position. If you play it properly, if you do the thing that you're supposed to do, there is value in your role. He is not sexist. Let's jump over to Judges chapter 4, verse 14. Let's look at the sister Deborah. Because again, the problem is why you don't see value in your role, why you would allow yourself to believe that the Lord is sexist is what? You don't sit down and study yourself. You don't read about your great foremothers like Deborah, like Rebecca, like Miriam, like Judith, like Tabitha, right? Many Abigail, many great sisters in the scriptures. But since you don't read, you say, God is sexist. Watch this. Come on, let's see what Deborah did.
This is the book of Judges, chapter 4, verse 14.
Uh-huh.
And Deborah said unto Barak, up, for this is the day in which the Lord hath delivered Sisera into thine hand.
Uh-huh.
Is not the Lord gone out before thee?
You see this sister, she didn't say, give me the sword and let me go out and fight. No, she encouraged that man in the Lord. So she didn't just say, you gonna go out and get the victory. She said, you gonna go out and get the victory because the Lord is with you. That's the type of encouragement that a brother needs. Read that again.
And Deborah said unto Barak, up, for this is the day in which the Lord hath delivered Sisera into thine hand. Is not the Lord gone out before thee? So Barak went down from Mount Tabor and 10,000 men after him. And the Lord discomfited
him. And the Lord, see that? And the Lord discomfited him because that sister, she had that brotherly love for her brother, right? Because that wasn't a husband. She had that brotherly love. And guess what? The Lord was in that thing because he saw the unity in that man and in that woman fulfilling their roles. That woman having his back. And that brother said, you know what? I can go out and do anything because I got these sisters support me, having my back. Right? Let's jump over to Sirach chapter 25, verse 1.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 25 and verse 1.
So again, Barak and Deborah, they wasn't married. Right, go ahead.
In three things I was beautified and stood up beautiful, both before God and men, the unity of brethren, the love of neighbors, a man and a wife that agreed together.
So a man and a wife that agree together is power in that thing. It's power in us fulfilling our roles. We can bring our nation back to the value of which it's supposed to have if brothers play their position and sisters play theirs. But guess what? We think the Lord is sexist because he got specific roles that he wants each one of us to play. That does not make him sexist. Let's jump over to Ezekiel chapter 34 and 31.
This is the book of Ezekiel chapter 34 and verse 31.
Okay.
And ye my flock, the flock of my pasture are men, and I am your God, saith the Lord God.
So the Lord said, guess what? His pasture are men. The men that the people that he wants to go out and fight and rule the government and rule the world, that is going to be men, sisters. There's no nice way to say that. But guess what? That doesn't make the Lord sexist. You will still receive and be in the kingdom of heaven, but you're not going to be out there on the battlefield launching and fighting with swords. That's not what's going to happen, right? Let's jump over to 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 9.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11 and verse 9.
Uh-huh.
Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man.
See that? So it's role. It's divine order. It's divine order. But that divine order does not make God sexist. He knows what's best for you and me. He knew what was best for birds and fish. He didn't say fish go live in the water he didn't say fish go live in the sky and birds live in the water. Nah, he knew what was the role for each one of those specific animals to play. And us as men, us as women, we have to accept the role that the Lord has put in place for you, children of Israel. Because again, this is about you, children of Israel, and us playing the role that we're supposed to play. Let's jump over to Sirach, chapter 32 and verse 9.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 32 and verse 9.
Uh-huh.
If thou be among great men, make not thyself equal with them. Mm-hmm. And when ancient men are in place, use not many words.
So again, even amongst us men, there's order, there's structure, right? He's gonna have men that's over other men, but that don't mean, oh, that's unfair. That's unfair. No, the Lord has order, right? Christ is gonna be above all. So am I supposed to say, you know what? I wanna play Christ's position. Nah, it's specific order. Come on, let's jump over to Proverbs 31, verse 30.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 31 and verse 30.
Uh-huh.
Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain.
Uh-huh.
But a woman that feared the Lord, she shall be praised.
A woman that feared the Lord shall be praised. If you choose to apply the commandments of God and fulfill your role that the Lord put in place for you, you will receive praise. And that's what we all after, right? Making sure we get into the kingdom of heaven. But nah, we want to have in our mind, you know what? God is sexist. You have allowed what America to tell you to teach you that. Let's go to this. Galatians chapter 4, verse 16.
This is the book of Galatians chapter 4, verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
So we told you the truth. God is not sexist. But guess what? Are there roles to be played? Yes. But the problem is that we have allowed, our sisters have allowed what America has taught them to supersede what Christ has put in place for us to build our nation back to the great nation that once it was, right? There are specific roles that we all have to play, and we can build our nation back to that greater state from the lower state that we are currently in. We can build ourselves back up if we accept our roles. But that does not make God sexist. With that, Israel, we say shalom.
Daniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.